what is the source of happiness?
Okay. This question, I have to spend more time on it because a lot of people ask me this question. It's important for us to explore it. Let me tell you my story. It's better to make it so personal so you think this is, I'm not just talking from some books. For source of happiness, where do we go? For example, at one stage in my life, I used to live in a huge house with a indoor swimming pool. I was, very highly, kind of commercial person. And I used to live in a huge house with swimming pool and all that. And I said, wow, we have made it. Look, beautiful house, possession, property, lovely property, beautiful. We have made it. We have really hit the jackpot. So it was yahoo, like that, just for a few hours, perhaps. And then every day we had to go and jump in the swimming pool. And then after a week, my daughter said, I don't want to go in the water. I am fed up. I don't need to go in the water. I said, but my daughter, we are spending £10,000 per annum to heat up the swimming pool water, jump in. So what appeared like bringing happiness became a chore, became unhappiness. So be careful. When you kind of focus on physical or material gain as the source of happiness, you'll really fall short. So in a way, this idea of trying to search for happiness in our material frame, in the material world, seems to fall short of the target. Try it out in your own life. Suppose you love to go on holidays. You want to go on cruise. Wow, well, yahoo, go. And then you say, I've saved money for the whole year, and we are going on a cruise, and we go to this Bahamas, wherever, and sit on the sand, and we enjoy, this is life happiness. I'm telling you, try it out. Once you arrive there, so far so good, and then you go on the beach, and the sun is out, the waves, everything is nice, and blue, beautiful waves. Wow, this is it, I've got happiness. Ask yourself, how long does it last? You get a spike, wee-hee, for 5 minutes, perhaps. And then the spike goes away. It disappears. And you get a bit of a kind of downside to it, downsize. And you say, now what do I do? How do I spend 7 days here? If I sit in the sun too long, I'll get, sunburned. And where is my lunch? And, the sand is getting in my eyes. And, what? In half an hour, you'll be fed up of your paradise. Again, you see, this is try it out on yourself. I mean, another example I use quite often is, because I teach at Eton College, and next door is Windsor Castle, where the Queen lives. So I ask the boys, look, boys, the Queen has got everything you can think of. Position, power, money, everything you can imagine the Queen has got it. So, of course, you would imagine that the Queen is jumping up and down, yahoo, euphoric day and night, I've got everything. Everybody bows down to me, calls me mom, and I've got, your crown and everything. So that you think the Queen should be euphoric day and night, say, yahoo, I've made it. Look at her face. She looks so depressed and bored. See what has happened? Searching for happiness in your material frame doesn't really produce the right results. It gives you a spike, and the spike drops, and you pay a price for it. Suppose you love to drink, I love alcohol, I could drink. You drink so much, you get a little bit of a fizz, and then next morning you get a headache, and for next 48 hours you are in trouble, you are puking. See, you pay a price for it. So this idea of looking for happiness in the material world is a very limited vision. And let me tell you now where I got some wonderful ideas. Harvard University conducted a survey which lasted 80 years in 1938. They had about 268 youngsters. They said, now we're going to follow the youngsters' life throughout their lives and see where they get the happiness from. This is serious, Harvard University research. So they followed these youngsters until they were in the 90s. In fact, John F. Kennedy was one of the candidates. And they kept quizzing these youngsters, where is your happiness from? Where is your happiness? And after 80 years of research, so these guys, many of them died. After 80 years of research, this is the result of that survey regarding the source of happiness. And you'll be very amazed to see this. The study says happiness does not come from property, possession, power. John F. Kennedy, look, power, or any other faculty like alcohol. Happiness does not come from any of that. You say, I thought this is where happiness lies. More property, possession, and everybody bowing down to me, and I've got power, I can tell people what to do. This surely is happiness. The research is saying no. And alcohol came at the bottom of the league. It creates more problems than solves your problems. So the answer is, where is happiness from? And this is why this Harvard study is very important. Look, suppose I say this is the Vedas, you say, who cares? Harvard University research on source of happiness, and you like the answer. They said the source of happiness they discovered is through relationships. If you've got steady relationships with your partner, with your family members, with your kith and kin, or with the greater society, that is a steady source of happiness. This is where you get contentment that you are happy in your life. So it is relationships that brings about happiness. He said, Mr. Lakhani, very interesting, but how does it relate to Hinduism? This is how it relates to Hinduism. You see, the Hindus say, look, anything that takes you back to your true nature, in a way, is good. And this is what is happening. When you start linking up other human beings, whether they're in your family or outside your family, you start linking up with them, feel comfortable with them, feel at one with them. You see, you are going back to your true nature. The thing that is percolating through these eyes is percolating through those eyes too. So when I build relationship with others, I'm in a way invoking my spiritual dimension. And that is the source of happiness. Didn't I tell you, happiness is bliss, priya. And this becomes visible, not through material things or even mental exercises or gymnastics. It comes through this linking up with other human beings, other living things. When you begin to feel one with other human beings, you are going back to your true nature as the spirit and not the body and the mind that you possess. And that is the source of happiness, linking up with other human beings. That is why my mentor Vivekan said something very dramatic. He said, they alone live who live for others. The rest are more dead than alive. There's carrions wandering about, munching these, eating these, running on holidays, going around. And they equate a frenzied lifestyle as a fun lifestyle. It's nonsense. The real fun style is when you are peaceful and calm and not a quivering animal. This is the message that comes out of Vivekananda and of Harvard University.